Hello my friends, it's Carrie and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I thought I would do something that I absolutely love to do, which is my favorite card making technique, which would be embossed resist. So I'm going to be using some products that is new to me. These are some products that I recently bought within the last couple of months and I'm just not getting to be able to use them. So I'm going to take this Rainbow Waves background from Tailored Expressions. All of their backgrounds are red rubber, and I love that because you usually can get a really great impression that way. So what I'm going to do is ink up my stamp, and I placed it already in my MISTI, as you can see. I'm going to ink it up with my VersaMark ink. This is a clear sticky ink and it's great for embossing. So I'm going to make sure that I get a really good amount of coverage of ink onto this stamp. And note that I did do this twice, but I won't be showing every step, single step, because I am doing two cards at once here. But anything that is like embossing or ink blending like that, you know, I'll show the initial, and I think I did show the ink blending of the second card, but I know that in this video I am making two cards at once here. So for my embossing powder, I'm using my favorite, which is the Brutus Monroe Alabaster. This is a great white embossing powder. I'm going to make sure that I get this really good and covered all over the background. Again, I'm going to do this twice. And then once I get all that covered, I'm going to take my heat gun, heat it up, and make sure it's really good and hot before I bring it to my cardstock so I can heat set both of these panels. And once I do, then it'll be prepped and ready to go for ink blending. So they're nice and shiny, and once I I'm embossing now, but once they get all embossed, you'll see they're going to be nice and shiny, and then it's time for the ink blending. Like I mentioned before, I really love doing this technique. It's my absolutely favorite technique when it comes to card making because it's magical. So I just kind of quickly showing you how I'm storing my ink blending brushes now. This is made at a container from Make It by Marco, I believe it's called, is the Etsy store. And I love this little peacock design of this holder, and I like it much better than the turntable, because the turntable wouldn't keep the brushes in place. So I was having a hard time with that turntable, so I decided to go ahead and spend the money and get this little holder for my ink blending brushes, which I really do like. And you can see them all at once like this. So for my ink blending, I thought I would take out my Catherine Puller inks. I haven't used these inks in a little while. And they are really great for ink blending. They've got really great saturation to all the inks. And she's got really beautiful colors in her inks. So as far as the products, I know some of you like to have specifics on what colors I used, or specific, you know, colors or products. Just to note, I'm going to be completely transparent with you guys. I'm kind of changing things up for a little bit because in the bottom of every video, usually I link below all of the products that I use. Well, I'm going to be doing a little bit different because whenever I do my links, that program that I use is LinkDeli, and I don't believe that there is a free version. You have to pay for LinkDeli. So all the products that I'm going to be I'll just list them out for you guys in the description bar area, but there won't be specific links to take you to those stores because right now I'm just kind of paring down my spending as much as I possibly can, since I'm going to school and I'm only working part-time and this, that, and the other. So I'm kind of, you know, cutting back on certain things that I really need to cut back on for right now. And LinkDeli is one of those things. So anytime I make a video here in the future, and then, you know, for a little while anyway, I'm just going to list the products for you guys. And that way, just wanted you to know that there won't be specific links to actually take you to that product. So I wanted to put that out there just to let you know that's what has changed in the description bar area. So anyway, I am going to continue on to ink blend this one panel, and I am, again, doing two panels, but I'm doing two different color schemes here. Obviously, I had to do one of them for rainbow, that's just a no-brainer, right? But I just love these colors, and I love how soft but still bright that they are. And I think this is probably my favorite out of both of them, even though I do like them both. But I am mindful of each time that I use a new color, or if I use a lighter color, I'm taking my rag and making sure that I clean my surface, because I don't want to contaminate my colors or contaminate my ink blending brushes. So I'm really being mindful of where the ink is on my work surface, that, you know, and such. So the next one I'm going to be doing is kind of like a pink to purple ombre, not ombre, pink to purple ink blending background. And I thought this would be really good homage to Valentine's Day. You know, those are really great colors for Valentine's Day. And of course, Valentine's Day is coming up this week, I believe. And so I'm going to do a lighter pink to a purple. And I thought that would be really fun to do, and something different other than rainbow. So I really do love these little ink cubes from Catherine Pillar. I don't use them as much as let's just get real. I haven't used much of anything in my craft room over the last few months, only to do the things that I really had to as far as design team projects. But, you know, I knew that going into whenever I started school that I wouldn't be able to dedicate as much time to crafting, which is making me a little sad. But I'm going to be happy that I got a video up for you guys today. So I hope y'all are actually doing well. I really do miss posting for you guys, but hopefully this video will get you through until my next one. So I really do love this combo of this pink to purple. It's really beautiful. And I just love the variations of all three colors. So in this one, of course, as you could probably tell, the background, I didn't get it quite center, but that's okay. I'm going to be cutting these down anyway with a stitched rectangle die. So, you know, that really didn't matter to me. I was going to cut them down anyway. Had that in mind as I was doing this. So now I am going to clean up my work surface and work on the rest of the card. And I'm going to go ahead and cut these down with that stitched rectangle like I mentioned. And now I'm going to work on my sentiment. And the sentiment that I'm going to be working with comes from the stamp market. I guess the stamp set is called Have a Nice Day. I couldn't really find an actual name of the stamp set on the set anywhere, but I figured that's what it is called because that's what the die is called as well. And I absolutely am in love with any type of sentiment stamp set that has a coordinating die with it. I got these during Black Friday, and this is the first time that I am using them. And I absolutely love how this, you know, big, bold sentiment has a die to it. It's just, oh, it just makes me so happy. I love doing backgrounds like this, you know, ink blended backgrounds or a background with a big bold sentiment. I probably more times than not, I really do like things like this or cards like this as far as me creating, than I gravitate towards, you know, like critters and stuff. I'd rather do something like this than take the time to color a critter. But I mean, I love those too. I just feel like that I don't have the time to dedicate to coloring these days. So these, you know, make, you know, satisfy my creative interests. So I just love how it just kind of cuts out the inner pieces of like the D and the middle part of that sentiment too. It looks so nice. I love this. And I'm going to hold it up to the camera so you can really see the detail of this die. But I just love how big and bold it is and how it can cover a card front. So now I'm going to go ahead and very much be fussy and add a bunch of little pieces of foam adhesive to the back of each of these sentiments, because I want to go ahead and pop this up. And it really didn't take me too long. It probably took me maybe 10 minutes, you know, to do both of them together. Off camera, I want to go ahead and cut down pieces of pattern paper as well. This is the Spiffy Speckles pattern paper from Lawn Fawn, and I thought that it would be nice to have that kind of spattered look in the background of these ink blended backgrounds. So now I'm going to go ahead and place my sentiments onto my main panels, and I just love the dimension of popping these up. And I'm just going to get some liquid glue and add these to my white card bases, which are top folding A2 size card bases. And I really do love this glue. The one thing that I'd probably say about this glue, I mean, it never gives me trouble as far as coming out of the nozzle or anything like that. But what it does do is you have to act fast with this glue. Once you get it in contact with like the actual card base, you've got to line it up really quickly because once it's down, you know, it only gives you a split second to move it around. It doesn't give you a long time to move, maneuver around, which that's the one thing I don't like about it, but I still love it enough to use it. So I'm going to go ahead and apply some liquid glue on the back of my main panels here and get that down onto my card bases. And that pretty much finishes up my card for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed so much this video. And I look at some of the products that I have bought recently, but just hadn't had a time to use them. And I hope it gives you a little bit of an idea on maybe some Valentine's Day cards coming up. So thank you all so much for watching. I truly appreciate it. Again, I miss you guys, and hopefully I can continue to post videos at least once or twice, you know, a month. And until then, I will see you in my next video.